FreakyDude99 here, coming at you with a Destiny 2 Arc 3.0 Titan build. Season of Plunder just dropped and Arc 3.0 is popping right now, and if you're a Titan, you're wanting to smash stuff. So let's jump into this Heart of Inmost light build. To start off, we're using Thundercrash, but you can use either super ability. For our class ability, we're using thrusters because popping a barricade takes way too long, and this pops our empowered melee and grenade way faster. For our melee, we're using thunderclap. This allows us to proc our empowered a lot easier and from a far range. For our grenade, we're using pulse grenade. Now, a lot of people are using Storm. Obviously, you can use Storm, but the reason I use Pulse is because it spawns Ionic Traces when we use the Touch of Thunder aspect. This allows our Pulse Grenade to make Ionic Traces as it damages its targets, as well as increases its damage over time. These Ionic Traces give us our ability back faster, so it's just feeding into a constant loop of grenade spam. For our second aspect, we're using Knockout, so when we punch guys, we get health back and we live longer. On to our fragments. Our first fragment, we're using Spark of Magnitude, so our arc grenades last longer, our pulse grenade lasts longer. For our second fragment, we're using Spark of Shock, so our arc grenades jolt targets. For our third fragment, we're using Spark of Focus, so after sprinting for a short time, our class ability regen is increased. This allows thrusters to come back quicker and for our Heart of Inmost Light to put in even more work. For our final fragment, we're using Spark of Resistance, so while we're surrounded, we get an extra bump to our resistance. This is going to help a lot in endgame content. Now for your weapons, it doesn't matter, except I am using Delicate Tomb as it jolts targets and it spawns Ionic Traces, which allow you to regen your abilities even faster. Now, moving on to the armor for our helmet. We have solar energy and we're running Bountiful Wells with Harmonic Siphon, Ashes to Assets, and a Resilience mod. For our arms, we are rocking Seeking Wells, Champion mods, and then a Resilience mod. For our chest piece, we're using the exotic Heart of Inmost Light, so whenever we use an ability, our other abilities regen faster and get a damage buff, or just a general buff. This helps a lot, as when we use our grenade, our melee and class ability comes back faster. So we just spam our melee, our class ability, and our grenade over and over and over. For the mods on the chest piece, we are using Melee Wellmaker, Arc Resistance, Thermoshock Plating, and Discipline mod. Obviously, you can switch out the Arc Resistance for something else. For the leg armor, we are rocking Elemental Ordnance, 2 Innervation, and then a Resilience mod. And finally, for the class ability, we're rocking another Elemental Ordnance, 2 Bombers, and a Discipline mod. So these mods combined together, what you are getting is you throw your grenade, you're spawning 3 wells. Whenever you punch an enemy, you're spawning 2 wells. You're getting your melee back faster, your grenade back faster, and your class ability back faster from Heart of Inmost Light. This creates just a spam build. For optimal use, you're going to want to use grenade, melee, class ability. Or grenade, class ability, melee. I tell you, just after this first day, this build performs so well, and I know as soon as we start getting some later artifact mods, it's going to perform even better. So, enjoy a little gameplay, and we'll see you in the next build. Peace out, everyone.